observe. I will explain one project. You know our project GCR shop application, that is dummy, not dummy project, sample project for practicing Selenium. That is our own project. It has admin interface as well as user interface. You can practice Selenium project. Before going to discuss that one, observe the purpose. Functional automated. Functional automated testing using Selenium. Functional automated testing using Selenium. See, manual testing also possible for functional testing. Okay. Now, already I gave the root at the beginning. Once again, observe Satya. Test level. Locate our Selenium. Our position of Selenium. Purpose of Selenium. Test level. What is our test level? We have 4 levels of testing in software testing. 4 levels of testing. What is our test level? Satya, what is our test level? Manual testing concept. We test have 4 level. Levels of testing. What is our test mm-hmm. level? In the Selenium point of view. Are independent testers point of view?
Like, it's the final level, right?
Final level, okay. See, we have 4 levels of testing. One is unit testing. Second one, integration testing. Third one, system testing. Fourth one, acceptance testing. In these test types, what is our test level? We independent testers.
We can do system testing.
Good. System testing. Testing on integrated system. System testing. Next, under the system testing level, test type. What is our test type? See, on integrated system, we can conduct several types of testing. Functional testing, performance testing, usability testing, etc. What is our test type?
Functional
testing. Functional testing. Next, test method. See, functional testing can be done in 2 ways. Manual testing, automated testing. Okay, using manual testing and automated testing. Our test method is in this point of view, Selenium point of view. Automated testing. Automated testing. Next, for conducting functional automated testing, we have several test tools available in the industry. Several test tools. What is our test tool?
Selenium.
For conducting functional automated testing, we have several tools in the market. What are the just idea? Selenium. Our tool is Selenium. We are going to conduct a functional automated testing using Selenium. What are the other tools that are available in the market, Savita? What are the other test tools? Just idea.
UFT.
UFT. Next, yeah. RFT. IBM RFT. Micro Focus UFT. Unified Functional Testing. Micro Focus is developer, vendor. That is commercial tool. IBM RFT, Rational Functional Tester. That is also commercial tool. Next, silk test, test complete, test partner, water, etc. Now observe, we conduct functional automated testing at system testing level, system testing level using Selenium. Okay, na Satya?
Yes, JC.
Observe, Selenium project. Save. First index, we will discuss 11 points. Observe. Project. Say, it is training program. In this training program, I am going to explain one sample project. But in real time, project explanation is not like this. That depends on your project environment. Some companies provide requirements documents and knowledge sharing programs. Next, reviews with business analyst, etc. concepts. But in our training, I will explain in our own style. Observe, Satya, you are working for one project. In your project, how they provide information, project information? They just send requirements documents, or they conduct any training sessions or meetings or any reviews, etc.?
User story. It comes in the form of user story.
User stories is one document, okay.
No.
Anybody explains the requirement, that one?
Yeah, the BA or the business, like whoever puts that, they do a grooming session.
Okay.
Like they will explain it. They will explain like what this is going to do, and so to both the developers and QA.
Yes. See, that the project or requirements awareness is required for both the teams, developers as well as testers. Okay. Anyhow, that project explanation depends on your company environment. See, in your company, you are getting that knowledge from BA, isn't it?
Yeah.
They give entire project explanation or only provide functionalities?
Just that story level, like the functionality they will explain.
Story level, story by story, each story.
Yeah, each story. What it is going to do. That small piece, what it is going to do. That's what they explain.
Okay. But they don't explain overall architecture of the project?
Overall architecture, it will be during the initial, like when the project starts, like they give the overview, what this project is going to do.
Yes, overview. Who gives overview? BA.
Not BA, business is the one who is going to, who is giving this to the team, right? So they do the explanation, like they say
means,
like what is the process.
Customer side people?
Yeah.
Okay. Depends on the project, depends on the company environment. Anyhow, you are getting project knowledge. Okay. Observe project information. See, in this training program, I am providing some general information also. But in real time, you may get this type of awareness in different ways. Depends on your project, depends on your company environment, sometimes depends on your customer also. See, project information. Next, project description. Notes I will provide. Just observe my explanation. Our project overview. Next, stakeholders of the project. stakeholders of the project. Any idea, Savita? Who are stakeholders for software project?
Who are involved in this project, sir?
Good. Who are involved in this project? Are affected by this project? Not only direct involvement, are affected by this project also. What is your opinion? Satya?
Yeah, do you think?
Stakeholders of the project. Who are the stakeholders of software project generally?
So when here, like, we use stakeholders means the client, like the business people.
Only.
That's what I thought, but here for the project means
no.
Like
whoever
might be
involved, whoever involved in this project are mm-hmm. affected by this project, all
okay.
are come under stakeholders of the project. I'll explain
okay.
the categories. Next, interfaces. Interfaces of the project. AUT, application under test. Next, features. Features to be tested in admin interface, generally we mention features to be tested, features not to be tested in test plan document. Next, features to be tested in user interface. User interface. These two are GUI interfaces. GUI means graphical user interface only. These two are GUI. Next, on general topic, it is not directly related to the project. General topic. Tester requirements. Next, test scenarios. Next, test cases and test data. Next, derive smoke test scenarios. Scenarios for admin interface. Admin interface. Next, derive smoke test scenarios for user interface. User interface. Now observe, Satya, you are involving a project now. What is the difference between smoke and sanity testing?
Smoke is for like deployment validation.
Okay.
Sanity, I think, like after deployment, we run the basic level of test, right? So that is called sanity.
Yes, good. Your understanding is good. Deployment validations. Smoke tests on initial build.
Yeah.
See, sanity. Sanity on stable build.
Mm-hmm.
And sanity multiple times na?
Yeah.
We conduct sanity testing on every modified build. Okay.
Yeah.
And one more thing, most of the time most of the time sanity test cases are static, isn't it?
Yeah.
Static means fixed.
It's fixed.
Next, regression. We conduct regression test cases. We execute regression test cases on every modified build. But regression test cases are dynamic. Dynamic, na?
Yeah.
We need to select. Tester need to select regression test cases for every new build based on the previous build execution. Okay, na, Savita, any query?
No, sir.
Yeah. Derive comprehensive. Comprehensive test cases. Comprehensive test cases. What are comprehensive test cases, Satya? Any idea?
Comprehensive, like, is it like end to end?
Comprehensive means end to end, okay. All possible.
Mm-hmm.
All possible test cases. After accepting the build, after sanity testing, if you accept the build, then you need to focus on comprehensive testing. Next, derive comprehensive test cases for user interface. Okay. Here, Savita, you try to understand test execution. Test execution is one phase of STLC, isn't it?
STLC,
software test life cycle. It is one of the phase in software test life cycle. Isn't it, Satya?
Yeah.
What are the other phases or stages in STLC? First one. Phases names may vary from one company to another, but purpose common.
Yeah.
Planning exercises.
Requirement gathering.
Requirement gathering is a phase of SDLC, software development life cycle. Testers.
Test planning.
Before test planning, requirement understanding
analysis.
And analyzing analysis. Requirements. Understanding and analyzing requirements. Next, test planning. Next,
implementation. Test implementation.
Without design, how can you execute test case?
Test case design.
Development. Fourth one.
Execution.
Before execution, one more stage is there. In some companies, they mix those two stages. Test the environment setup and conducting smoke tests for verifying the environment. Fourth one, test the execution. Fifth one, test execution. Next, last one.
Test closure.
Okay. Now, test execution is one of the phase of STLC, software testing life cycle or software test process. Here, we have some levels of testing, Satya. some levels of testing. Levels of, not levels of testing, levels of test execution.
Okay.
We are saying test execution. Okay. But we have different types of test execution. First one, after smoke, sanity testing. It is also test execution. What is the purpose of sanity testing? Verifying
detail
whether the
basic functionality
acceptable or not by conducting basic functionality test cases, isn't it?
Yeah.
Verifying whether the build is acceptable or not by conducting basic functionality test cases. Here, finding defects is not the purpose. Whether the build is acceptable or not, verify that one. Sanity test case. Here, we focus on basic functionality only. Example, login light. Next, suppose redirect functionality is there in our application. Redirect. Redirecting from admin to user interface. That is not basic functionality test case. Suppose if it is not working, then no issue. But that is also important. But that we will concentrate on comprehensive testing time. Suppose if our application is not redirecting from admin to user, then no issue. You can launch user interface with user interface URL directly. Okay. But login. Suppose if login is not working with, if login is not working for valid data, then you can't forward. So, build is not acceptable. Okay. Sanity testing. Next. Comprehensive testing, complete testing, executing all possible test cases. Here we try to execute all possible test cases. Suppose if any showstopper is there, then we stop testing temporarily and wait for the fixation of that showstopper. Getting?
Yep.
Next. After during comprehensive testing, we report defects and track defects, track for status. We report defects. Next, after getting or after receiving modified build, then we go for
regression
testing. Actually, regression testing. Full form is retesting and regression testing. But we are just saying regression testing, regression test cases like. But full is retesting and regression testing. Otherwise, you can use like this. Re and regression testing. Retesting and regression testing. The full form of regression. What is retesting? Any idea? Savita, what is retesting?
Testing frequently, more than once.
No.
To find the bugs have been fixed.
Default retesting.
Default retesting is regression. Defect retesting is regression. Observe. Here regression test cases means executing last time failed test cases to check whether the test cases are passing this time or not. Passing or not. Executing last time failed cases comes under executing last time failed cases comes under regression testing. Next, retesting means executing last time passed cases. Why last time passed cases? Last time passed, but some test cases depends on failed test cases. Functionality dependency is there. Due to modifications, if any side impacts are there or not, we need to check. For that, we execute last time passed cases also. Not all, only dependent test cases. Getting this point? Savita, Satya.
Sir, regression means testing. What to say like? Regression testing means testing the failed test cases or fixed test cases, making sure it does not affect any other wheels or any other test. That's the regression testing, sir. I know.
Yes, but we are full form is re and regression testing.
Yeah.
Now observe Satya, first test case we executed, pass. Second test case, pass. Support, third test case, pass. Next, fourth test case, failed. Okay, now. Executing this test case on modified build is called
modified build is regression
testing. Okay, test case 1 passed, 2 passed, 3 also passed, but 3 and 4 test cases are functionality dependence. Due to this defect fix, if any side impacts introduced or not in this third test case, we need to check that one. Last time passed, okay, but what about this time? Functionality dependency there with test case 4. In test case 4, modifications happened. With that modifications, any side impacts introduced or not, we need to confirm that one. Suppose executing this test case on modified build only. Is called?
It's retesting.
Retesting, observe Savita. But we no need to execute test case 1 and test case 2. Why? They already passed in previous build, but no relation with failed. So, we no need to execute those. Test case 3 also passed, but dependency there with failed test case. That's why we are executing. On modified build, we need to select these two test cases. Any problem, Satya? Savita?
No problem, JC, but I don't think this is the case with all company. Yeah, so what actually in our company we do is like the critical scenarios they put under regression, and then like that regression, say I have 10 scenarios under regression suit. So if there is like
failed test cases, failed test cases you select for regression, ma?
No, sir. Failed test cases generally we select retesting, sir.
Retesting.
Yeah, that's what we do. We retest and then like we
just a minute. This one
to see whether
Just
it
a
has
minute.
been effective.
Misplaced. Just a minute. Misplaced. My. This one misplaced. Abbreviation
Yeah, fail test cases, like we will be validating the defect and the retesting it. So with that, we will re-execute this fail test case.
This one.
Yeah.
This one. Just explain it, but replaced the terms. Observe Satya. Executing last time failed test last time failed test cases, retesting. Executing last time failed cases, it is my mistake only. Executing last time failed cases, retesting. Why? We are checking once again. We are checking once again. Regression means executing last time passed test cases, but dependency is there with the failed test cases, so that we are checking for side effects. Now continue, Satya.
Yeah, this is okay.
Actually, terms misplaced. Actually, Savita told correctly first. I only rejected.
Yes.
My mistake. Savita told correctly. Yeah, yes. Last time, executing last time failed test cases. Retesting. Yes. Re means again executing. Regression means it is also executing again, but last time passed cases. Due to verifying the side impacts.
Just to make sure, like the impact, there is no side impact. Yeah.
Yes. Suppose this test case depends with failed test case, but any side impacts are there or not, we need to check. If you exclude this one, again it is passing, then no issue. Last time passed, this time also pass. No issue. Okay, na Savita?
Yes, sir.
Now
sir.
Tell me, Satya, in your project, this explanation is okay or any difference are there?
No, this is okay.
Hmm.
Yeah, this is how we build the regression.
Okay. Actually, I misplaced this these terms. Regression, last regression on last time passed cases, re on last time failed. Okay. Re and regression testing. Test execution levels. Sanity testing, comprehensive testing, re and retesting and regression testing. Here, comprehensive testing on of comprehensive testing only once. After sanity testing, it is first level of testing after sanity testing. But re and regression test cycles multiple na.
Yes, sir.
Suppose this is cycle one. During this cycle, after execution, defect reporting and tracking for status. After that,
defect tracking and then they are closing the cycle, right? Testing cycle.
Not complete cycle, na.
Retesting, so defect reporting and tracking.
Again regression, na.
Oh, if there is any defect, yeah.
Before regression, observe. Select test cases for regression. Cycle 2. regression cycle 2. Okay, na? Before regression cycle 2, again we conduct sanity, na?
Yeah.
Again sanity. Next, after that, these regression cycles depends on the complexity of your application as well as strength of the development team. We can't restrict these regression cycles. Next, after getting confidence on the build, we go for final regression. This cycle is final regression. In this final regression, we focus on high defect density areas. See, this conducting regression cycles, general regression, final regression. Final regression means after getting the confidence on the application quality, once again we confirm with the final regression. Final regression time, we select test cases from high defect density areas previous. This is the structure. Any variation in your company, Satya?
No, GP.
What about you, Savita?
Yes, sir.
Okay. There will be UAT, but UAT, user acceptance testing.
See, in some companies, parallelly, they may conduct.
Yeah.
The acceptance. Okay. User acceptance at the end of the execution or every cycle of the execution?
Only when QA like confirm that we go story level, right? So after validating each story, like we move that to the business and business validate and then mark it as complete, something like that. Yeah.
After executing of all test cases or
no, not all test cases, story level. So
story level,
say for example,
means, okay.
Yeah.
They confirm each and every story.
Yeah, each and every story. Depends
on the project. Some customers involve in multiple phases of test life cycle also. Some customers involve at the end of the execution. That depends on the project.
It's a story by means, sir, it's
a
agile, right, sir? Agile testing.
If it is agile life cycle, for every iteration, that user interaction is required.
Yeah.
And one more thing, in agile development also not single stage of development, multiple stages. Suppose 1,000 requirements are there, we have to develop. We have to develop the software application with 1,000 requirements. Example, they don't develop the software at a time, like waterfall or V model. First they divide the project into iterations. Suppose 10 iterations or 20 iterations. If they divide into 10 iterations, first they take 100 requirements. 100 or something, 10% of requirements, and build the system. Next, after getting the customer feedback, they add 10% requirements. Like that they build the system. In this agile life cycle, in every iteration, customer interaction is there. So it takes time, it takes efforts, but less chances of failure. Quality is guaranteed. Any? Savita?
No, you're saying like we'll go by stories. That means it comes under as well.
No. That user stories concept may be there in waterfall model or agile model or any model.
Okay.
But agile structure is entire different. From scratch, they involve customers involved in the life cycle project development. Already I told na, in agile life cycle, every iteration is one mini V model. What is your model, Satya?
Ours is agile, GP.
Okay, in agile, user interaction is there. Without agile also, at the end of the project, they may involve. But this is agile level na. It is agile na. Testers point of view, they are involving in execution. Testers point of view, they are involving execution. But developers point of view, just a minute. If you are following agile model, then multiple iterations na.
Yeah, we have, we call that a sprint actually.
Prints, yes, that is one term. Iteration, multiple prints. That time, this process also not sufficient for that one. This is general process. I think you have to follow this process for every print na. What I explained, test execution levels, it is general general process in waterfall or sequential models. This is sequential process. Suppose if it is agile, I think this process is there in every print or iteration. Maybe there. You need to test complete system at a time na. You don't need to test complete system at a time na.
Yes, GC.
Only increments na. Only increments or prints. See, one general point, observe Savita, every iteration or print of agile is one mini V model. Getting. Now tell me, Satya, any variations?
No, GC.
What so, about you, Savita? Okay. Now I'm providing one general info, project information. And one more thing, Satya, for agile testing in agile life cycle. For agile testing, automation is more suitable, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why?
Because new functionality keeps getting added.
Increments
regularly.
So if it is automated testing, once you design test cases, you can execute those test cases multiple times easily. Okay.
Yeah, correct.
Observe. project information. It is general orientation. Observe, suppose our project domain, e-commerce. Any idea, Savita? What is domain? Domain means an area. That is general meaning. Domain meaning depends on the scenario. Suppose www.icicibank.com. That is web domain. Web domain. Ours is software business domain. What is domain in our area, Savita? Domain means?
As of I know, like bank domain, health domain.
Yes, they are examples. Banking domain, yeah. Healthcare domain, yeah. Insurance, telecom, combined domain is there. BFSI, ERP,
retail
market, travel, etc. What is domain? Yeah. Project business area.
Project
area. Software project business area. Suppose our application is online shopping. That is for e-commerce business. Suppose our application is online banking. It is for banking operations. Project business area. See. Software project. Business area. Okay. Next. Popular domains. Observe Satya. Popular domains in the IT industry. Which one is the largest domain in terms of value? Not revenue. Value.
Banking, I think.
Banking is largest domain in the world.
Maybe healthcare, I think. Healthcare, right?
Okay. See, largest domain in the world in terms of value.
E-commerce.
Yeah.
ERP.
No? ERP, okay.
Okay. E-commerce also important one, but ERP is largest domain in terms of value, not in terms of revenue, in terms of value. Biggest, why? For every industry, any type of industry, for every industry, this enterprise resource planning is required, isn't it?
Yeah.
See, earlier, we can develop, not we, developers. We can develop ERP software using Java technology, Java with backend, Oracle, etc. We can develop ERP software using Java technology or .NET technology, but some efforts required. Nowadays, for ERP development, so many software packages also there. In order to simplify the efforts, in order to simplify the process, SAP is there.
Mm-hmm.
It is only for ERP development, na?
Yeah.
Oracle Financials. So many ERP softwares are there. Specialized packages. Next. Combined domain is there. It is largest domain in terms of revenue. BFSI. We heard this domain name, Satya. BFSI. What is BFSI stands for?
I think it's banking, financial.
Good. Banking, financial services and insurance.
And insurance.
And insurance. Combined domain. For some financial services, banking and insurance integration also required. The type of projects comes under, the type of projects come under BFSI. Banking, financial services and insurance. Next, independent domains. Banking, only banking operations, primary operations, banking. Next, insurance. Next, telecom also popular domain. Telecom. Next, healthcare. Next, nowadays, e-commerce also evaluating. Next, a retail market. Next, travel, etc. Others. Observe Savita. Games also one domain, isn't it? Nowadays, games,
yes,
testing also there, na? Games software market also nowadays. Very good. Games software. This is our domain. Our domain is e-commerce. This is not required. This is not required. Subdomain. Just go to in-depth. Subdomain. Our subdomain, Savita, under this e-commerce, business to customer, B2C. B2C. Do you hear this term B2C?
That's
business to customer. Customer. Observe in this e-commerce area, B2B, business to business projects are there. Business to business. Next, business to customer is customer C2B also there. Customer to business. Next, C2C also there. C2C. B2B, B2C, C2B, C2C. Can you give one or two examples for C2C? C2C project. Satya. I think you may be using that one, okay, regularly. That C2C. Sites.
Customer to customer.
Customer to customer. I think all of you familiar with this one. Customer to customer. Okay. Suppose this one.
Amazon, Flipkart, those come
Amazon,
under
B2C.
Business to customer, right?
Yes. Vendor post their business. Customers purchase their goods.
Take it.
Goods and services.
Yeah.
That is business to customer.
Customer.
B2C means online classified portals are there, na? Suleka.com, OLX.
Okay.
They are come under C2C. Customer only
customer.
Post the requirement or selling. Another customer purchase that one. Customer to customer, na? Example, online classified portals. Okay. Now, application. See, this much classification not required. Just I am providing. Application. Application area is online shopping. Next, application type. Application type, public web application, public web application, internet application, actually online shopping portals are public web applications. Another is private web applications also there. Intranet applications are specific to some companies. Intranet application. For example, ALM is there, application lifecycle management from Micro Focus. That ALM tool is intranet application. Private web application. Private web application. Suppose defect management tool Bugzilla is there. Bugzilla also private web application. Next, application environment. Application environment. Here application environment means observe Satya, in software development we have two types of environments. One is development environment, another is testing environment. Development environment is different from testing environment, na?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What I am going to provide is development environment. Development environment. Not, I am not providing complete development environment. Development technologies. Technologies used for development. Development technologies. Here development environment means operating environment and application environment. Both come under development environment. Development technologies. This application developed using LAMP technology. LAMP. I think all of you familiar with this LAMP. It is open source. Savita, what is LAMP? LAMP stands for?
No, no, sir.
I think Satya.
First time I'm here.
Okay, cool. Satya can hear. Satya can answer it.
I don't know, GC.
Okay, cool. LAMP. Linux. A for Apache. M for MySQL. Next, P for Hypertext Preprocessor, PHP. This is open source. Some web applications use this technology. Basically, small scale. See, this is about project information. Information. Okay, na? Any queries? Satya, raise query regarding this project info.
No question.
Primary info. Next.
No question.
No, welcome. What about you, Savita?
No questions.
Welcome. Project overview. Say, notes I will provide. In this software application, we have two interfaces, two GUI. One is admin interface, admin interface. Second one, user interface, user interface. Admin interface or another name, server side interface. Next, user interface are client, end user, client side interface. You take any project, any software project, you will have two interfaces. Database interface also there. That is not accessible for all, only database administrators or admin users. You can connect to your database and perform some operations. Database interface also there, but these two are the primary interfaces. Now tell me, Satya, what is the purpose of admin or server side interface for any application? Purpose, generic.
To serve the request coming from the client.
To serve the
A request coming from the client.
Okay. Okay.
So this interface.
Yes. Okay. Okay. See, first one is application. Application master data. Master data. Your master data. Add, edit, delete. What is master data? Any idea, Satya? What is master data?
Master data. Master data is
required data for running the application. Required data for running the application. Suppose one bank application is there. Client side, we log into the bank application, for example, online banking. I will check for, I will verify my balance. After that, fund transfer. Suppose I want to apply any loans, I can search for available loans. For example, industry loans, personal loans, education loans, etc. Suppose if I want to deposit something, I can search for types of deposits that are available in the bank. That loan information is there now. Suppose industry loan, education loan, personal loan, etc. Who provides the data? Admin user provides the data in admin interface. Then end user can access that data. Suppose healthcare application, lab module. Suppose in lab, in our hospital lab, we have 20 types of tests. Blood test, x-ray, etc. X-ray, 220 rupees. Blood test, 100 rupees. Who provides that data? End user access that data. Suppose if any patient comes, then he enters that the patient details. Suppose x-ray. If he select x-ray, then 220 rupees can be applied. Who provides that data? Following, Satya? Any confusion?
No, JP.
Getting or not?
Yeah, I'm getting.
Okay. Who provides that data? X-ray 220 rupees, blood test 100 rupees.
Admin.
That is master data. Suppose next month onwards, we are increasing the prices. Blood test 120, next X-ray 240. Admin user edit the master data in admin interface that can be reflected to user interface. Suppose next month onwards, we are adding one new test or removing one existing test, admin user delete that master data. That is master data, required data for running the application. For example, Savita, in online banking applications, you can find bank info also, branch locators, ATM locators, etc. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Who provides that branch locators, that address, ATM address, addresses?
Admin.
Admin. Yes,
yeah.
Admin provides the data in admin interface, then user can access that data. Otherwise, that raw system doesn't know about the branch locators and ATM locators. Admin provides master data. See, this master data management is important task for admin Satya. Any query? Next. Maintenance. Maintenance of the application. See, customers provide the transactions na from user side, user interface.
Yep.
For that data, data processing is there. EDP, electronic data processing, will be there in every software application. But admins need to monitor that one. Maintenance of the application. Application. In this maintenance, Savita, user maintenance also there. User management. We use different types of users, na? Hello? User management. Next. Operations management, etc. Transaction management of the application. Now Satya, raise query.
No query, JP.
What about you, Savita? Raise query.
That's clear.
Next, client interface or user interface. What is the primary purpose of user interface? It is for every application, not only our application.
End user can, not end users, the clients can access it, like customers.
Clients access customers, okay.
No,
okay.
Clients or customers can access that online facility.
Suppose online banking is there.
Yeah.
There are no bank employees interaction, only end users means account holders. Guest users also launch that web application. But only specific operations. They can watch, they can view bank information, branch locators, ATM locators, loans information, credit card information, etc. But they don't log into the system. Okay.
Yeah. Other
two. If it is account holder, account holders can access all the features, maximum features. Conducting or perform specified business operations. Specified business operations. Example, if it is online banking, what are the specified business operations for account holders? Specified business operations, balance inquiry, fund transfer, bill payments, request for checkbook, request for ATM, etc. Those are business operations. Now tell me, Satya, give your input. What about Savita? Give your input.
Yes, sir.
Here in these online shopping applications also, we have two types of businesses. See, primarily. Two types of online shopping applications. One is type one. Vendor develops their own online shopping portal. Portal means business gateway. To sell their products. Next, type two. Some third party develops online shopping portal to sell and buy products. It is for all. Anybody can sell and buy the products using this portal to sell and buy.
Like Amazon and eBay.
Yes. Products. Our application is sample application. Our application is second type, Savita. Second type. Can you give some example? You already giving na?
Yeah.
What are the?
Yeah.
Amazon. Flipkart. eBay.
Flipkart.
Snapdeal. All these come under.
Yeah.
Second one. See. Flipkart is not the vendor of all the products that displayed on their site. They provide interface between vendors and customers, and they get some commission from vendors. Getting?
Yes.
Next, first type, vendor develops their own site to sell their products only. Nowadays, second one is largest area, first one limited area, but nowadays this type of portals also there. Observe Satya, me.com, China, Xiaomi, this me.com is there na, it is also online shopping na, you can buy and sell na, not sell. Selling only by that me. You can buy na? It is first type application. First type na? Why first type? They don't sell others' products. They sell only their products. Alibuy.com. Me.com, all these are vendors only portals. Okay, na Savita?
Yes, sir.
Suppose if it is Amazon, you can find different types of vendor products, Sony, LG, etc. But here, through this me.com, they sell only their products. Ours is second type. Ours is second type. Okay. In admin interface, I'm providing the overview of the project. In admin interface, observe. Login is one functionality. Admin login, that is not the business functionality. In admin, after login to the application, add, edit, delete, add, edit, delete, manufacturer. Next, add, edit, delete, category, category. Next, add, edit, delete, product. Product. Next, reports. Reports. Customer wise, product wise reports. Next, one more. Add, edit, delete, and set as default. It is also one functionality. Currency. Currency. See, it is not full-fledged application. Full-fledged application, we implemented some core functionalities only. Observe this one. URL this one. GCRIT admin. Observe Savita. Admin. Admin at 123. See, after logging to this application, here add manufacturers. You can add, insert means add new manufacturer. Edit,
okay.
Delete manufacturer. See, in large scale applications like Amazon, Flipkart, not only admin, they give login to admin interface for manufacturers also. Manufacturers create their products information and update their stock also. But it is small application. Here, everything is done by admin user. But in large scale applications like Amazon, Flipkart, admin provides login to manufacturers also. Manufacturers create their categories, create their products, and update the stock also, and process the queries also. Any customer reports, getting?
Okay, got it, sir.
Customer, sometimes customers send queries, we are not receiving
yes.
so and so product, like some that is recall is there na, return, product returns,
yes.
they need to handle.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So large scale applications like Amazon provides separate login for every vendor. They manage their details. Admin of Amazon or Flipkart maintains that complete site operations, overall operations. And one more thing, Satya, in large scale operation, large scale projects, not only single admin. One more concept also there. Super admin is there na?
Yep.
In some applications you can find super admin. Under super admin, some admins may be there. One admin for handling manufacturer queries, one admin for handling currency like queries, one manufacturer for processing financial services requests, financial service providers like PayPal, banking, payment gateways are there na?
Yep.
Admins. Super admin, admins. But if it is small scale application, a single admin is enough. Okay. Next here, category. Add category. Suppose TV is category. Product, under this product, 17 inch, 20 inch, portable, large size, home theater, like different products. Next, localization. Here, currency. That manufacturer provide the buying options in different currencies. They can set as default currency also. Next, reports. Product-wise reports, product purchased reports, best products purchased, customer orders, total reports like. Here, what are the important, business operations are there in this admin interface, Savita? Admin login is not business operation, isn't it? That is core functionality. Yes. Core functionality of the application, but not business operation, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Adding,
adding, editing, and deleting manufacturer, business operation. Next, add, edit, delete category. Add, edit, delete product. Add, edit, delete, and set as default currency. These are under reports, product-wise reports and customer-wise reports. Okay, this is about overview about admin interface. Next, user interface. I think all of you familiar with user interface. Nowadays, we are watching so many online shopping portals now. Forget about admin interface. Admin interface is not accessible for end users. Our say sample application, you can access admin interface as well as your user interface. But in real time, in production means usage of
when it goes
usage of the application. In production environment, end users can't access admin interface. Only user interface. Okay. In user interface, I think all of you are familiar with this user interface functionalities. Can you tell me, Satya, what are the important functionalities or business operations in this user interface?
Login.
Login. Okay. Without login also, you can launch the user interface, na?
Yeah.
You can.
Yeah, that is okay. Yeah,
you can launch the user interface of the application. You can view the product. You can view the products. You
view can, the product.
You
buy
can
the product.
For the product, not buy. For buying the product, user user registration is required. Login required. As a guest user.
Guest user.
You can view the products and search for products, etc. But if you are a registered user, you can buy products and you can report also, or track for your product status, track for your order status.
Even as a guest user, you can buy, right?
Buy
by giving
while buying reason. While buying, it asks registration.
Not on all sites, sir.
Not on all sites.
See,
Because you can give the credit card detail and just purchase actually.
Okay, but in some sites, okay, that depends on the application. That depends on the application. If you want to buy, you can give your credit card details or through internet banking. But shipping address required, na?
Shipping address is required.
Shipping
that address, we can give one.
Shipping address is required. But some applications, suppose that food delivery applications also, Swiggy, Zomato, etc., they also ask for registration, not mandatory nowadays. They ask for phone number and they send that, what is that one? Code.
Confirmation.
That code, after entering that code, they will ask for address, etc. Okay, nowadays, customer registration is not mandatory for all the sites, but for some websites, some web portals, online shopping web portals, registration is mandatory. You have to give your email ID, etc. But in some websites, you can directly purchase as guest user. If you give your payment details, if you fulfill that payment requirements using internet banking or credit card or something, they may accept. But you need to give your shipping address at least, isn't it? And one more thing, and one more thing. If you register to this type of applications, one advantage is there. What is that advantage? You can track your order now easily.
Yeah, you can track order.
They may send to your email or phone. That is different. If you have registered account, you can track the order. If you want to cancel that order within specified period, you can cancel that order, you can return that order, etc. Okay. Any other? Say here, view products. View products. View products. View products. Next, product search. Product search. Next, advanced search. For advanced search, you need to provide some more details now. Here, observe, this is just a view on desktop. Oh, old students entered off data. Now, observe, here, quick find, search is there now. Here, you can just enter one term, one key pass. See, TV, it is showing available TVs. Suppose advanced search. Using advanced search, you can locate the exact product, na? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Using advanced search, you can locate the exact product. Price from to price range, date range, manufacturer, category, etc. Okay? Next, any other operations? Any other business operations? Overview of the application. View products, search products, advanced search. Next, customer registration. Customer registration is there. customer see this application not implemented completely, some core functionalities only. Customer registration next. Customer login next. Satya, contribute.
Customer registration.
Shopping cart is there na?
Yeah, add to cart.
Shopping cart is there. In the shopping cart, you can add products. You can add products.
Yeah.
Add products, one or more. And you can update the default. Default value is one product. Suppose if you want three similar products, you can get this one. For buying, it is asking login in this application. Customer login. Next.
Registration, adding products.
Next. Shopping cart. Shopping cart. In this shopping cart, what are the operations?
Adding product, deleting product. Updating.
Add product, one or more. Next, update, quantity, default quantity is one for every product. Next, suppose you added 10 products to your shopping cart, but at the end of the process or for buying, you want to remove one product out of 10. Yes, you can remove from your shopping cart. Remove product, etc. Next, this is about shopping cart. Next, checkout is then a checkout process.
Yeah.
Shopping cart. Checkout process, both are combined, okay, combined, but it has some functionalities. After login, you can get what is the password? ABCD321. ABCD123. What is the password? ABCD321. Not working. 1, 2, 3. Observe, Savita. This is checkout. Shopping cart and checkout. These two are sequential functionalities, na?
Yes, sir.
Sequential.
Yeah.
That the checkout is dependent on shopping cart. Okay. Here observe the functionalities. Here observe the functionalities. Child requirements. Shipping address is there. You can change. This is shipping address. Example. You can change address na? Checkout. In this checkout. Change address. Change address. It is optional, Satya. It is optional. But but functionality, but yeah. You need to check this in comprehensive testing. It is optional. Already address is there. We entered this address while registration. If you don't want this address, you can change address. Next, shifting method is there now on functionality.
Yes.
Comments optional. Add comments. Next. Payment method is there now. Suppose cash on delivery, PayPal, like. Here, we need to check this one also. Payment method. Next. Payment method. Suppose cash on delivery. Continue. Order confirmation. Once again, view the all details and confirm. Otherwise, suppose you are navigating through this functionality mistakenly, or you forgot one modification. Here edit functionality is there, na?
Yes.
You can view this. You can view these details and confirm order. Otherwise, you can edit. You can edit the delivery address or something. Okay. Oh, it's not coming to back. Continue. You need to press continue. Edit before order confirmation. Before order confirmation, edit details, purchase details or buy details. Edit details. Next, order confirmation. Order confirmation. See, I selected one product, address already there. I gave that address during registration. It is asking, it is taking that registration time. My address, it is taking that address as delivery address. See, payment method cash on delivery. Confirm order means completion of checkout process. Confirm. Your order has been processed. Okay. Log off. See, these are the core functionalities. Okay, na?
Yes, please.
Savita, any query? Did you understand this user interface?
Yes, sir.
Fourth point I will explain. Tomorrow we'll continue. Fourth point. I think you are already familiar with this one, interface of the project or UAT. You may find this type of deployment in intranet environment. In internet environment also you can find this one. Admin. See, admin interface. Admin interface URL. Here login required. Username. You can practice with this username. Next. Password. Admin at 123. Next. User interface. User interface, you can create your own login. You can create account. You can create account. What is the admin? What is the user interface? Login is not mandatory for user interface. Okay. Now, just observe, Savita. HTTP. You know this one. What is HTTP? I'm not asking functionality of that one. Just what is that keyword? Is it a protocol or something? Satya.
What do you think? HTTP?
HTTP is protocol, na?
Protocol. Yeah, protocol.
Hypertext
transfer protocol.
Next, suppose if you find Google .com like HTTPS, S for security. S for security. Hypertext transfer protocol security. Okay, I think all of you are familiar with this one. And one more thing, all of you know, if it is internet application or intranet application, we conduct software testing in intranet environment. Okay, for some applications, some 5 to 10% testing on internet environment with live data. That is not only for all applications. Getting this point? Raise your objection, Satya. If it is internet application or intranet application, we conduct testing at intranet environment.
Yes.
Some percentage, 5 to 10% testing can be applied in internet environment with live data. That is only for a few applications. www World Wide Web Consortium. Next, gcreddy.com. gcreddy.com. It is domain. Domain. Domain na. World Wide Web Consortium. Domain. Next, what is this build 3, Savita? What is this build 3?
What, sir?
What is this build 3? Suppose gcreddy.com. Domain. HTTP is protocol. What is this build 3? / build 3.
Worldwide web, sir.
World Wide Web.
Build 3.
Admin. I think Satya can answer it.
A path, right? Like the page.
Page. Page is HTML. Admin. Okay. Build 3. It is folder.
Folder.
Folder. Next. This is subfolder. Now just observe. News web portal tupaki.com. It provides news in Telugu as well as English. Now observe. here tupaki.com is domain.
Domain.
What is this English? What is this English? English.tupaki.com. Tupaki.com is domain. Okay?
Domain.
What about that English?
Is it a folder?
Pardon? Subdomain.
Well, the word.
Subdomain.
Okay.
See, you need to familiar with these terms. Domain, subdomain, folder. See, subdomains and folders most of the time similar, but SEO, search engine optimization point of view, some difference are there. And one more thing, if it is a subdomain, you can you may have duplicate content also. And one more thing, subdomains and folders. If you have subdomains and folders, you will have different interfaces. Getting this point?
Subdomain and the folder.
So if you have subdomain or folders, both are some similar. You will have separate interface. Observe tupaki.com. Tupaki.com is domain. It has news in Telugu. Telugu interface. Telugu. Observe. Where is that one? This is main domain na. Here. Telugu na. Next English. Subdomain. Mm-hmm. It is different interface na.
Okay.
Just a minute. GCReddy.com is main. Main. For example, observe. ISTQB. What is this ISTQB? ISTQB.gc.com. It is for ISTQB mock tests. It is subdomain na.
Yes.
It has different interface na.
Mm-hmm.
Home.
It brings, for example, relevant
software testing forum. What is this forum? It is also different interface. What is this forum? Is it subdomain?
Yeah.
No.
No. Yeah. It's a separate folder.
Folder. After domain / folder. Before domain, subdomain dot domain. Okay, na?
Yes.
See, nowadays web applications may have this type of subdomains and folders. Some applications may have both subdomains and folders. Okay. Today I'm going to close the session. Tomorrow we'll continue. Any queries regarding this today's topic, Savita?
No, sir. No queries.
Welcome. What about you, Satya?
No question, JC.
Okay. Okay. We will meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.